Hello everyone, I'm the Saxy Gamer, and today we're here for the very first of the Humankind guides. I am going to be doing guides for this game, just like I have with Civ. I'm planning on doing some beginner basics, which is what this video right here is a part of, as well as some in-depth videos, maybe some culture spotlights, things of that sort. But I figured we'd start this off by just going into some of the very, very absolute basics of the game to help you learn. As I learn this game as well, I'll be sharing my tips with you because, you know, it's always a learning experience anytime we have a new game. And as always, if you'd like to pick up this game while supporting the channel, you can do so at my Nexus store linked in the description below. So what we're talking about today is adopting your cultures. So this is a critical part of Humankind, and unlike Civ, you don't just pick a leader at the start, you evolve your culture throughout the ages, and we're going to talk about how to do this and what exactly you're going to be looking at when you're looking at this screen. So in order to transcend to a culture, you need to get a number of era stars, which are seen up here. So in pretty much every era, it's going to require 7 stars. The exception there is the Neolithic era, in which you only have to get one of them, and in that era, it'll show you what you need to do here. If you're wondering how you can see what you need to do to earn these stars, you can come to this screen and then hover over any of the icons, and you can see that it will tell you what you need to do. So, for example, this Builder Star, we need to have 18 districts built within our empire, and we currently have 16. Once you reach the required number of stars in order to transcend a culture, you can do so by clicking Show Cultures, or if you're already at that requirement, it'll just come up whenever you click this menu over here. And you can see that it will give you all of these choices of what we can go to for the next era, and there are a few that other people have taken. So these are given out on a first-come, first-served basis, and we'll talk in a little bit about why you would want to either claim yours first or perhaps wait until later before you transcend cultures. So if we take a look at one of the little menus here for any of these cultures, we'll see a number of things, and these are all very important. So up at the top, we have the culture affinity. So these are things that are kind of given as a class to the various cultures, and multiple cultures will share these same bonuses. So you can see that the Axumites right here are a merchant culture, which means that they are going to be focused on earning their merchant stars and will earn more fame from earning those merchant stars. All of the affinities also have both an affinity action and an affinity bonus, which are pretty much like active and passive abilities. So you can see here for the merchant one, you can use your influence to marshal venture capital towards a resource deposit, either creating an extractor or generating money. And we also have this passive bonus as well. And you'll see that if we take a look at one of the other merchant cultures, such as the Carthaginians, they will have those same bonuses. So these are kind of like the focuses for each of the civs that are in this game, and although they are not unique to each civ, they are still important to consider based on what type of playstyle you're going to want to do going on into the next era. We also have our unique legacy trait that is given right here. So you can see for the Axumites, it is the Horn of Plenty, and this is the passive ability for your empire that will carry with you throughout the eras as you transcend further cultures. So if I go back to this screen here, you can see that we are going to be getting this ability from Egypt, who we are right now, for the rest of the game. So for the rest of the game, from this era onwards, we will be getting +1 industry on tiles producing industry and a discount on district industry costs. So if we go to the Axumites in the next era, then from that point onwards, for the rest of the game, we will get this +2 money on tiles that are producing money. This can allow you to chain things together in order to get a sort of interesting build as you evolve your culture throughout the eras. So there is a lot of things that you can think about here, and a lot of interesting combinations that you can choose by going through various legacy traits. Below that, we have the emblematic district. Every single civ has an emblematic district, so you can see for the Axumites here, it is the Great Obelisk, and this is pretty much a replacement district for one of the other ones, so you can see this one counts as a market quarter that will replace the market quarter while we are in this era. The emblematic quarter, or the emblematic district, can only be built in the era in which you are having this culture. So right now, as the Egyptians, we have the Egyptian pyramid, and if we are to transcend in the next era to someone else, we will no longer be able to build any Egyptian pyramid. So make sure that while you are still having your culture, you get these districts down. Another thing to consider here is that you can only build one of your emblematic districts per region. So you can see over here, if I go out of this menu, that I do have 2 of these in the city of Memphis. But the thing here is that since these are in different territories, if I zoom out here, you can see the little pink dotted line in between. I'm able to get one of these per territory, although you can have more than one in a single city. So before you want to consider transcending your culture, make sure that you build all of the emblematic districts that you want. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to build them once you transcend to a new culture. And then down here at the bottom, we also do have our emblematic units. So these are basically the unique unit for each civ. And these do replace other units as well. And the thing with these is, unlike the emblematic district, You are able to build these even after you transcend to a new culture. They go away then once you are able to build like the next unit in the upgrade tree, essentially. So if you have built some of these units here, you're not going to lose them when you transcend eras. You're still able to even build new ones, but whenever you research the technology that then makes them obsolete, you will no longer be able to build them. The last thing that I want to talk about is why you would choose to either wait until you transcend a culture or transcend right away the second that you hit 7 era stars. And there are pretty much 2 reasons that you would want to do that. So for one, the reason why you would want to immediately transcend your culture is if there's one that you really know that you want to get. So as I had mentioned, these legacy traits will stick with you throughout the entire game. So if you have a particular plan in mind for exactly how you want to work your way through history and you need a specific culture in order to do that, then you probably want to transcend as soon as you're able to. Otherwise, somebody else might take the culture that you want, and then you'll be out of luck as far as your strategy goes. You'll have to change it. The reason why you would maybe want to wait out on transcending your culture is for a number of reasons. For one, you maybe want to stay in the current era in order to get more of the era stars. So you can see that there are 21 available era stars in the ancient era that we're in right now. If we transcend, we're effectively giving up on the rest of these era stars. The other reason is that you might want to wait to build more of your emblematic districts, because as I mentioned before, whenever you transcend, you're no longer able to build the emblematic district from your previous culture. So if you haven't finished building all of your Egyptian pyramids and you have 7 era stars, you may still want to wait in order to get these down before you transcend into a new culture. The last thing that I actually want to mention is what happens whenever you decide that you want to keep your culture. So you can transcend into the next era while also keeping your culture. And the only thing that this does is it's going to make it so that you get 10% additional fame gain in the next era. You're going to keep the same legacy traits, same emblematic districts, same pretty much everything. You're just going to get 10% extra fame in the next era. I generally think that this isn't like particularly a good idea. If I was going to want the same culture, I would rather just wait to transcend rather than taking the same culture again. So although this is an option, it's not one that I have found myself taking very often thus far. Hopefully after this video you now have a little bit better of an understanding of what each of the unique aspects are of the various cultures in humankind. So thank you everyone for watching. I have been the Saxy Gamer. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to like. If not, feel free to dislike. If you're looking for some more humankind content, feel free to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.